Yo, 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 welcome back to the fifth round. As always, myself, Steven Musteris. And man, I'm super fucking hyped for this weekend. UFC 266. I mean, honestly, it might be like household name-wise, might be the most stacked card of the year. I mean, seriously, it's ridiculous from top to bottom. Main card, like I just said, all household names. The two, the main event for the prelims and the co-main, household names. And it actually takes me right into the first fight I even want to talk about. And usually I don't spend too much time on the prelims and stuff. Like I'm a diehard fan, I would like to say. So like I do know a lot of these guys, but to like talk about them and things, like I don't know. Sometimes I just you almost don't know enough about these fighters sometimes. And then they almost it's their coming out party, so you kind of let these fights happen, and then you kind of like share your opinion on them. But I mean, this is the return of Dan Hooker ever since his knockout last year of Michael Chandler. And then the fight before that, we all know, is Dustin Poirier's classic bout with him and Dan Hooker, where they're just a fucking battle. And he takes on Nasrat Haqparast. Sorry if I said that wrong. Very familiar with the guy. He's been in the UFC since, I think he signed in 2016. First fight was 2017. He's lost a couple in the UFC, but honestly, right here, this is like one of those ones that. It's like, yeah, last year, I think, maybe even 2019. I can't remember which one, but he had that 1 minute loss to Drew Dober, got knocked out. But other than that, I mean, he's going to be there all night fighting. Dan Hooker brings the same style. So it's going to be really, really fascinating to see which Dan Hooker comes out. Like, I think the entire MMA world was shocked that Michael, like, don't get me wrong, we all know Michael Chandler's the truth and whatnot, but to come over to the UFC and then knock out Dan Hooker, who just went five fucking rounds with Dustin Poirier, almost had him out of there in the third round if it wasn't for the bell, and then Dustin just kind of took off on it. But it's like we haven't seen Dan Hooker get knocked out ever, and for him to have that entire battle, it's pretty fascinating. But see him come back finally, I'm really excited, and it's this one's tough right here because it's honestly, if you really look at it. I would really be all on Dan Hooker's side right now. It would be all my money on Dan Hooker if he wasn't battling these issues outside the ring, but or the octagon. But I mean, if you really look at it, since this whole COVID thing, and especially he lives in Australia and whatnot, or New Zealand, which one? But I think it's Australia. But it's like their protocols and stuff are ridiculous. Like I think it's a full like 3 week, 2 week program or whatever. As soon as you land and whatever you're about to fight. And then whenever you get home, it's like I think they say you're quarantining like pretty much almost a whole month after your fight, before and after your fight. And I mean, him and Tiger Muay Thai with Israel Adesanya and all them, they travel with each other all the time. You hear stories left and right about how they're so busy quarantining. And then this big travel ban and stuff, the travel visa and everything was really tough. It seemed like a bigger fight than his fight coming up, if that's even possible. To even get him ready for this fight. And I know just a couple of days ago they finally officially announced like, hey, this fight's happening. So this one of those fights I'm probably not gonna put money down on. I think a safe bet would be Dan Hooker just because of the sample size. We've seen him fight, higher competition and whatnot, and no offense to Nasrat or whatever, but like he's definitely fought the who's who compared to him. But this easily could be one of those ones where it was like I don't want to consider like Dan Hooker a Tony Ferguson type, but I mean we've seen him go on a really good win streak. Setbacks to Dustin Poirier, which that loss you can't be mad at because that was a really good fight, really close fight. But I mean, of course, the loss to Michael Chandler. I mean, that's probably got you feeling a way. But I don't know. It just could be one of those fights, though. It's like you expect this person to come out and be the same style and same person as he was before, and then this new guy comes up and. Shows us like, oh, he's old, he's out of his prime, even though Dan Hooker isn't that old still in his fight years. He is old, he's been fighting forever. So I don't know. I would like to say Dan Hooker wins this one. I'm really excited to see him return. I think he's one big win away from Nasrat to being right back into the mix. I mean, I'd like to see him fight a lot of people. Like, good Lord, there's a 255 or a 255, 155, like it's stacked there. So I'd like to see him pretty much against anyone. And still, just remember this guy, like I just said, almost took out Dustin Poirier, but he just finished Gilbert Burns only like 2 years ago in 2019. Gilbert Burns, we've seen the hot streak he was on. So I think Dan Hooker is really far away from being out of his prime, and I think he's got a long fighting career still upon him as long as he takes it serious. And I don't know, I think he should walk away with this one. But yeah, I'm really excited to see him return. And if I had to pick, I'd like to see a finish within the first two rounds. I think his kickboxing level or Muay Thai level, whichever one, is just out of this world. He's phenomenal with elbows, phenomenal with knees. Just a gritty fighter, always in there. Really hard to take him out. That's why it was so impressive Michael Chandler did it. So, but and then if Nasrat can do it, Nasrat's right there too as well, to like fighting the Beneil Dariushes in life and all these people in 155. So even like a Tony Ferguson matchup, something. He's right there. So I think it's gonna be pretty cool. And the fact this is even on prelims, I don't think a lot of people are gonna see it, but I think it has a chance to be talked about. Because if regard Dan Hooker comes back and wins, oh, Dan Hooker's back. But if Nasrat comes out and knocks out Dan Hooker or finishes him or gets a good dub, we got a new guy in 155. So, and an already stacked place. But hey, this is the fifth round. As always, myself, Steve Musteris, and let's go, baby.